if I look doesn't look nice now, watch out for later. Yo yo yo, what's poppin', what's good? Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So as you can tell by the title, today's video is gonna be this glam makeup look. So this makeup look is inspired by I Love Sarahi. I changed it a bit because like skin shade, like it doesn't match, so like yeah, change it. I'll insert a picture of her look here if like she actually took a picture of it, but without further ado, let's just get into the video.
Okay, I've just done this eye off camera and I used the P. Louise Secret Center palette. I'm just gonna do this eye and show you how I created it. So we're first gonna go in with the P. Louise Rumor Zero base, and I'm just gonna put a bit on the back of my hand because the one that I put on before is just like kind of running out. And then I'm gonna be taking this Morphe R39 brush, which looks like this, and I'm just getting a bit of product and then just tapping it on my eyelid. And then because there's still gonna be product on it, I'm just gonna wipe off the excess on the back of my hand, only because I don't have all of them fancy palette thingies. And then I'm just gonna be blending that up into the base that I put on before to conceal my eyebrow. The reason I do this with this white shade is to make the colours that I actually put on just pop. And yeah. And these bases, they like set in 60 seconds. So like as soon as I blend this out, I'll have to quickly go in with the eyeshadow. So this is what it looks like now. Then I'm gonna go in with the Morphe R37 brush, which looks like this. I think it's like a tapered blending brush, and I'm going in with the P. Louise palette. The first shade I'm going to be using is Love Shy, and then this shade Love Struck. That's the shade, that's the two shades I'm going in with. One's like a burnt brown shade, the other's a burnt purple shade. If you guys don't know, I have TikTok. I'm trying to become like Charli D'Amelio out here because, you know, everybody knows who Charli D'Amelio is right now, right? So if you want to follow me on TikTok, the thing will be down below. I'm just building up the colour so it doesn't look patchy in some places, and then blending it out. So now that's done, I'm just going in with this Moda domed shadow brush, which looks like this, if it's gonna focus. And then I'm taking the shade Love Truck and putting it where like my crease is. This is just to add a different type of color, so it's not just one burnt purple shade, you know what I mean? Now I'm taking the R37 brush to just blend that out too. So now that is done, I'm just going to be cutting my crease. So I'm just going to go in with the R39 brush, and then I've packed on a bit of Rumor Zero on the brush, and then I'm just going to pack that on my crease. But now I'm going to go in with this flat brush from the Acid Rain collection, P. Louise x Mitchell, and I'm going in with Rumor Zero again, and just to carve out the crease. That bit that I did before was just to easily do it and for me to see where I actually want the crease. But because this crease isn't the main thing in this situation, the eyeliner is, so that's why I don't want to do a big overlined crease, because like there's no point. gonna be taking this brush from the P. Louise Mirror Mirror brush collection, and I'm going in with the shade Obsession and Fling, and I'm just gonna pack that on the crease. So now that is done, I'm going back in with the R39 brush, taking the shade Love Sh, and now I'm just going to be blending out that harsh line from the cut crease. Now we're going to do a liner. So I have two eyeliners that I'm going to use. I'm going to use the NYX one and the Morphe one. The NYX one is just called the Vinyl Liquid Liner. The Morphe one is just called Blackout. So first I'm gonna go in with the Morphe one, because like it's got like a dense, this bristle brush, whatever you call it, it's really dense and it's easier than like one of them brushes that just go if you get what I mean, like when you put on the liner the brush doesn't, it doesn't go out and then like the line isn't straight, if you get what I mean. So like my camera just stopped, like it always does after every 24 minutes. It basically took me 24 minutes to do this. I look wow. Okay, so now I'm going in with the Morphe liner. This is just to fill in the rest of the thingy. I'm so scared because there's a video that's going around on TikTok where someone's like got eyeliner and put it in their eye. Like how could they do that? That's scary. I don't know why I'm holding my liner like this. Badass, baby, what you looking at? I'ma throw that back like care how you throw it on my handle, like I'ma break this bitch. So I'm getting this angled brush from the Acid Rain collection, I think. Yep, from the Acid Rain collection. I'm getting the P. Louise base in Room at 11. I'm just gonna put a bit on the back of my hand. Imagine. It took seconds to go back into focus. So annoying. First I'm gonna be taking a wipe and I'm gonna be wiping off that excess eyeshadow that I blended out over there. And now I'm going in with that brush and the concealer, well, the base. Now I'm just taking this blending brush. This is the brush that I use to just blend out concealer after my eyebrows. I was gonna say eyeshadow. I'm just gonna dip my brush into it so it actually blends out more. And I need to see if both of the lines look the same. They kind of do. So we're just gonna allow it. Hashtag we me. Someone said we should leave that in 2019. That's why I laughed when I said it. I'm just gonna be taking these two glitters. One's from Makeup X More, this one. And I don't know where this one's from. But I'm gonna use this one first because it's got like a thicker brush. This one has the thicker brush. So I could just gradually put this on and then fill the rest in that I need to with this other one. I nearly dropped the glitter. So this is what the eye look be looking like. It's cute or whatever. I basically do eyelashes after I've baked my face because when I want to get into here, like this side, it's really hard when I've got my lashes on. So now we're just going to move into the face. But to prime my face, I'm going to use the Fenty Beauty, MVP Brow. The Fenty Beauty Hydrating Primer. Oh, I didn't show you what it looks like. It looks like this. And the Too Faced Hangover Art X Primer. So I just put it on my face. I use this brush from Moda Cosmetics, if I can find it. Okay, no. I use this one from Real Techniques. It's called the Instant Pop Cheek Brush. But you know what? We don't use brushes for what they're actually called, if you get what I mean. Now I'm just going to blend it out. We don't use brushes for their actual purpose. That's what I wanted to say. Okay, so now I'm just gonna be mixing these two foundations together. This is the Fenty Beauty Hangover. This is the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Hydrating Foundation. And then this is the NARS Sheer Glow Foundation. This one's in the shade Zambi, and then this one's in the shade 450. And I'm just gonna mix it together on the back of my hand. Okay, so I got the wrong foundation out. I was supposed to be using the Fenty Beauty, I forgot what this one's called, Soft Matte Foundation, on the back of my hand like this, and then I'm gonna mix it together. I'm actually a weirdo for getting the wrong foundation out. It's only because like I'm so used to the hydrating foundation. I'm just gonna be taking the Morphe R6 brush to just blend all of that out and all the way down to my neck. Best believe that after this I'm gonna be doing some TikToks, and then I have to clean up because my mom's acne. I should film more makeup videos. I really like doing, but like I'm still conscious of people going, oh my gosh, she thinks she's a makeup artist, oh my gosh this, oh my gosh that, and like who does she think she is? And then literally, have you not seen them quotes about 2020? It's gonna be about who does she think she is. So you know what, I'm not gonna care. Literally, if it's popping out a makeup video every 2 weeks, literally I do makeup nearly every, not every day, I do makeup most days, and it's basically just for fun, so I might just film it because like I've got the P. Louise winter bases and the summer bases. Is it called the summer bases? I don't know. Basic Brights. Okay, I've got that Basic Brights collection and I haven't tried it out, so I might try that out in the video. And then I've got the winter bases that are really good, and basically I'm just doing these looks and then not going anywhere except from on my Snapchat story. And I'd rather do videos with them because like basically to show what I can do and put it into a video too. I might start that next week. So I'm just getting my tray of beauty blenders. I know they're dirty. Every time they're dirty, I always buy some more from PLT. Just never got around to doing it. I'm just gonna be taking the back of this brush and just blending all the foundation in. If I feel that I need more, I'll just go from the back of my hand because I've still got some there. This eye look doesn't look nice now. Watch out for later. So now I'm going in with the e.l.f. 16 hour camo concealer. I think it's like the Too Faced Born This Way concealer, but like it's not in stock in my shade, and then I go broke, and then when I have money again I want to buy it, it's not in my shade, and then I go broke. So like, will I ever get that concealer? I mean, yeah, concealer. We'll see. Because it's like with the NARS one, I could never get it as well because never in my shade. So that's a big problem. There's more in this one. I've got two. That's because it's a New Year's Eve glam look, that's why I'm going in this hard. So I either use this P. Louise brush from the Mirror Mirror collection or this MAC 252, but today I'm just gonna go in with the P. Louise one because it's not that dirty. I'm just gonna be patting all the concealer out and then being careful next to the liner. I don't even want to go back to college, not gonna lie. It's not even that it's boring, I just don't like it. It's not what I thought it would be. Now I'm going in with this matchstick from Fenty and it's in the shade Espresso. I don't really know what it does to my cheeks, but I just do it because I have the product and I like it, and I don't know. Now I'm using this brush from Unicorn Cosmetics. I don't know what it's called because I got it in a P. Louise mystery box. I'm just gonna be using that to blend this out.
basically I have these like lines under my eye. So I was watching Jaclyn Hill. I've always been watching Jaclyn Hill. The video that I watched ages ago, she said to get concealer, but when you get in the concealer, you should blend it into the line, because like the creases are always going to be there. So like there's nothing you can do about it. I just get extra concealer for that little bit and then use a brush and blend it in. So now I'm going in with the Huda Beauty loose and setting powder, and I've already shaked it, so as you can see this product there. Taking one of my PLT beauty blenders, I'm just gonna be baking my face. The thing about this powder is that it sets really nicely and it smells so good, literally. And I put this powder everywhere that I like put concealer, and then here just to chisel the cheek, even though it doesn't really chisel the cheek because I'm gonna put bronzer over it. I'm just gonna be getting my eyes prepped for lashes. I'm just gonna be using two different lashes from Bahama Lashes, and I'm gonna stack them. So the ones I'm gonna be using are Tatiana, which are these ones, and then Coco, which are these ones. I'm putting Coco at the bottom and then Tatiana on top. I'm using Duo Lash Glue. This is a brush on lash glue, so it's easier. Now I'm gonna be putting the lashes on with my fingers because like my tweezers have disappeared. I have 3 tweezers, all of them have disappeared, and then I just started getting used to putting lashes on with my fingers. So this is how it goes. So this is what Coco looks like. I might just leave Coco on and not put Tatiana on top. We'll see. I'm just trying to like feel myself in these lashes and see if they really need Tatiana on top. I've just put lash glue on one Tatiana lash. I'm just gonna put it on top of the Coco one, and if it doesn't work out, then I'll just take it off. Okay, that just, whoa. That just brings extra vibes. So I'm just gonna try and put it on properly. Okay, this makes it look like a really thick lash. This is what it looks like. I'm gonna be taking it off because like, we need the eyeliner to shine. Eyeliner needs its moment. We'll save these lashes for another moment. Now I'm taking this Morphe X Jaclyn Hill brush. It's called JH03, and I'm just using this to just buff and blend out the powder. Now I'm going in with the Patricia Bright X Revolution palette. This one's called Dusk Till Dawn, and this one's called You Are Gold. I'll show you what they look like. This is Dusk Till Dawn, and this one is You Are Gold. So I'm gonna be using the blush shade from the two palettes. Let's go in with this one because it's a lighter one and it doesn't do more. No, I'm not even got. See, I don't even know my own routine. I really first go in with Fenty Beauty. It's called Sunstalker by Fenty Beauty. Yeah. We have a brush missing. This is crazy. Just using this Morphe brush. I don't know what it's called because it's in a collection. I'm just going to be bronzing up my face. I really need to find that brush because like I really, really need it. Because this doesn't do the job anymore. This is just a just in case brush right now. When I take this band off, I just put bronzer on the actual thing because like there's no point in putting foundation, concealer, powder, highlighter. Like no, there's no point. I used to put all of that on the lace, so like it wouldn't last. But I've had this on since Saturday. It's now Monday, so we're doing good right now. Now we can go in with the Patricia Bright palette. I'm just gonna be using the shade. It's like in 1, 2, 3. So this is the third one. This is a blush shade. I'm gonna be putting that on with me. Then I'm gonna put the other shade blusher on too. And because this one's more intense, I just do dot dot dot. I'm just gonna take this brush from Moda Cosmetics and I'm just gonna blend it out.
I will always stay loyal to this highlighter, even though it looks dusty. I might buy a new one if Beauty Bay still sell it, but it's the Doso Colors Desi X Katie highlighter. I only like it because the packaging, like, it's so shiny. And then it's in the shade Mirame, and it looks like this. It's like a really pretty rose gold highlighter. I'll just swatch it for you guys. It's intense in the summertime, and it's just so pretty. I'm just gonna be putting this on the high points of my face. Like, you see that glow? Even though it needs to be blended out, you see that glow? So now I'm just getting this flat brush. I don't know where it's from, and I'm just gonna be putting highlighter on like the bridge of my nose and then the point. I got told that it looks better to use a small brush instead of a really big one. Oh, by the way, I have two of these brushes, so like in a different video, if you see me using like one brush for the same thing, you should know that like I've got two of the same brushes. So the pencil that I'm using, it's not even a pencil. Oh, the ghetto. It's in the shade dark brown. That's why it looks really nice. I'm just gonna line my lip. And then I go over it with MAC Chestnut, because it's like a lighter brown. And MAC doesn't have anything darker, which is a bad. That is like setting on my lips, so I'm just gonna go in with my Too Faced. Okay, so now that's dry, I'm just gonna be getting my lip gloss. It's a New York lip gloss. You can get it from a beauty supply store, a hair shop, basically. I'm just gonna use this and put it on my lips. I just shake the table by accident. I start in the middle of my lips because there's no color there, and then go out. And then because like this lip gloss doesn't have a wand, I go in with the Glossier. Yeah, I said it. Glossier lip gloss. So after that video, I just wanted to try it out. I just got lip gloss, brow gel, and I think a moisturizer. But I still don't see the hype on Glossier, guys. So I had to charge my camera battery. Now I'm just gonna be doing my hair. All I do is brush it. Oh my gosh. And then because like it's done, I just get one of my bronzer brushes and just try blending some bronzer, the actual lines, so like it doesn't look weird. And then I just take this olive oil super hold spray and just I just spray the top only, so like it stays down and flat for when I take pictures. It's usually 9 o'clock, and I'm gonna take this off soon. But yeah, this is the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. Don't forget to follow me on TikTok. I'ma skip town, see my wrist drown. Everybody wanna fuck with me for benefits now. Man, I wish my nigga smelly could've seen me lit now. Sit down, maybe roll up, blow a spiff.